You gotta be kidding me. This game. Oh, come on. Hi, what is good, survival veterans? Whoa, that was real close. Tino here.
Don't move a muscle.
The second episode of the lethal zone. As you can see, I just need to point it out. I wouldn't put it into the title for no reason. So yeah, just had
this
a break in
a
between.
To us.
Oh, that is nice. So that's what I explained the last episode. That's why this door is now unlocked. As soon as you log out, maybe you'll find a rucksack. Please give me a materials rucksack, I need that. There's a high chance to find them within warehouses and storages and the big supply. Thank you. Nothing more to say. And these should also provide me, yeah, only a permanent safe area. There are other warehouses that provide you the material collection. For example, Huey's Hardware or whatever it was called in here, or this warehouse is a bigger one that will provide you materials. Perfect setup that I'm giving you right from the bat that I'm always using is either one for food or one for med, depending on what facility you have and how many survivors that need an approximate number of food units. If you got an hydroponic that covers up with a compost bin and the activated seed and some of agriculture, 10 or 11 food units, you don't even need a food outpost in my opinion. So I go with 1 to 2 material outposts. If I don't get the water and legacy water and power legacy boon from the builder called amenities, I'm using 1 for power, using water rain collector on my base itself. But then on the other hand, I'm using a like I said, power on the second. So maybe 1 for beds instead of having a facility in my base, but in this case I don't need any. I already got 4 beds, which is a neat benefit of the Firewatch Fortress. If you go up to 4, because that's why Providence Ridge is my favorite map, you can either move to a great base called Rusty Rose or the Fortified Truck Stop, or, in my opinion, I'm always saying it, I know, best base in the entire game, 6 customizable small auto, or not small auto, but 6 customizable out. I'm saying it again, 6 customizable small slots and 2 customizable large slot, as long as you, 7v3, you get also 2 large slots. If you clear the Clio, failed Clio drop, or you got a hacker, so you don't need the manpower of 8, but you can build up to 4 survivors in here and instantly move to one of the better bases. You only need 1000 influence. Because there is no medium base, no bigger base, only 2 large and 2 smaller bases. So, lumber mill, because the lumber mill is the actual biggest base in the entire game. If you take away the, what was it called, the dinosaur, was it not Jurassic Junction? I don't know the actual name, but the, what's that, come on, kid, why are you doing, what are you doing, Kid Harrington, there's a bloater ahead of us, so, yeah, except that, it's the biggest base in the game, the lumber mill, because it has the most large slots, the entire game. But they're all outdoor slots, so you can't build certain facilities. Yeah, food is something we need, and that. I'm honestly just eager. Okay, so now zombies aren't just suddenly appearing, they're also disappearing. They're getting warped back to Star Trek Enterprise. Scotty warped them up again.
Rest.
Yeah, I got to be very careful with my stamina. And there you go. Down goes Frasier.
Down goes Frasier! Down goes Frasier!
So we got some peace here. And I was thinking about already abandoning my 2 others members, because it's actually BS what I was talking about, because until I get access to toolkits, I need to have a level 2 workshop. Actually, I can already install that one. And until she gets interesting with munitions, it will take hours, literally, because we're on lethal zone.
Get a few more hands working and, here, it sure make my life easier.
I pick all the things you won't need, I can sell that one.
But you really have to leave.
Don't pretend you're not happy about this.
Oh, I'm really happy. I'm having a blast here, playing alone. Maybe the ranger house over there might provide me some...
That's enough looking around for now.
I'm going to loot the same things that I recently did in livestream with a fresh community with Bundy and Congrex's Prime, because we're doing a fresh start with a challenge. He calls it the Three Amigos, and we have one shared supply locker, only the one from the host. So in that case, Congrex's Prime is supply locker. And too close to the medium zone, to the orange encumbrance. Yeah, we also went the same way, and Prime likes to call it Three Amigos. Like, we are sharing the main supply locker, so everything we find we can either bring into our own supply locker, but nothing... Well, we are not allowed to pick anything from our supply locker. And it's an only livestream thing we're doing every Friday on Prime's channel, because he's the host. And I mean, not practically every Friday, but most Fridays, as long as we all three
Looks
have
like
time for
else
that.
Is home.
Oh, that is awesome. The Ranger tool chat. So we were wasting some time in here because, as you know, one survivor, so I'm never trying to keep my fast search at a minimum, at a bare minimum. And yeah, it's actually turning out to be more fun than I thought. I mean, of course it's heavier, but we already killed in the first 3 hours like 6 or 7 playcards. Considering we haven't killed any playcards within the first, like, I don't know, 1.5 hours or something, or 2 hours. And I almost lost one of my private survivors, my most recent and best ones, the one that I made a vid on it, on her, Gia Ju. So I had to quickly quit the session, send her into my infirmary, heal her, because I'm not allowed, I'm actually allowed, but I can't heal her within the foreign community that is not mine. I have to go out, send them manually to my infirmary on my safe and all that stuff. Okay. It's a lot of stuff in here. I need to equip that.
This will slow me down.
This place has outposts written all over it. No sight nor scent of Zeds. Is that it? Let's hit the road. We're done here. No place but that.
The thing is, why I'm not refueling my thing to make some spaces and hope, or I'm actually hoping to find a better vehicle. So I'm dropping off my things, drive back here, and then drive all the way to the next cell tower. You gotta be kidding me. This game. Oh, come on.
We got a lot of people singing the blues around here.
I almost got him, but then... Why isn't she going down? That's when 100 laps promise you a thing that they can't hold up. World War II. They said zombie executions and finishing things will be prioritized over interactions like with doors and item containers, stuff like that.
Headshot now! I got no time for this.
Yeah, well, it's still BS. But anyways. This game, Jesus Christ. This game prioritized nothing that was important. The door was absolutely unimportant.
I'm gonna need a lighter load soon.
Hey, we prioritized zombie finishers first.
I feel like shit.
Nonsense. Okay, the weapon is still not reloaded. It's too slow.
I can't keep this up.
You need to reload faster. Look, so slowly, like he's worrying about nothing. Like there's nothing to worry about. Ridiculous. I don't trust those guys. And I got both. Here we had all the ammunition. And then ethanol. And then I'm halfway or even more. Full again. And I need to get away first here and then to the cell tower. No, you don't scream. Egypt. Stop it. I don't need any trouble. Okay, mister, I just spawned in this room.
We ain't alone, of course.
Yeah, I dodge and get cheated on anyway.
Last one left.
That's the way this game works in Lethal Zone. Dodging has no value. Certain mechanics and commands just fail you whenever you need them, like gunslinging, especially in multiplayer against ferals, but hey, I don't want to complain all the time. After this location, I think I'm going to survey either off screen or finish here. Okay. Well, it can't be silenced, so I'm taking that. Even though it has a full auto mode only. And it needs, I think it was, yeah, I'm pretty sure 9mm.
I already got all I can handle.
So we got enough already to kill Blackheart. I mean, the first one can be killed by kicking it down or spamming with a heavy weapon. I'm pretty curious how many I can finish off in this playthrough. Okay, it's a bladed weapon. Not really better than mine because it weighs way more. But it can be salvaged for 72 parts, which is a lot. No, 45. Sorry, 45 cals, not caliber, not 9mm. Uh-huh. Neat. That is neat. Hopefully I don't forget them, because I want to see what's... Oh, it might be up there. No, it's not up here. It's here in this little tight box.
Well, we found everything we can possibly find.
Awesome. Mark this location to remember me. But I got some spare 45 cals in the tight box. Alright, I got no door. Wanted to kill him with a door. Oh, I see some trouble over here. It wants to be driven over. Splat. Me alone. I killed both.
I see a plague bloater.
Yeah. So we're currently still at level number 0 on shooting. Why am I actually looting? I'm full. Yeah. Hopefully there's a red vehicle close by. Oh, the stamina is already killing me. I'm hoping for marathon as my specialization. Oh, there's still one spot that I haven't covered with my firewatch tower. Vehicle? No. Is there anything for me that I... Okay, over here. Alrighty. Stuff has been dropped off.
People are gonna get sick unless we score more meds.
What people? It's just them? Or you and me? Not a lot to survive with. And the stamina's depleting. But well, that's it for this episode. Once again, thanks a lot for tuning in. And have a great day. Bye.